The labyrinth of life. I enjoy a grand lifestyle next only to the Pharaoh. I am the most powerful man in all of Egypt now. Seeing my sons play with each other, my childhood days come flooding back. I can still smell and feel the fabric of my exclusive multicolored coat. Me, the favorite son of my dad. My dreams that sketched out my future alienated me from my brothers and made them so jealous to put me on sale when I was but a teenager. As I was being hauled to Egypt, my heart was heavy for my dad. How will he survive my separation? I became part of the Potiphar family, his favorite slave, only to be falsely accused and shut up in jail. As a reputed dream interpreter, there too I rose to be a favorite prisoner. All through my roller coaster life, I believed God was in control. For 13 long years, I learned how to endure hardship, undeserved punishment, and wait faithfully. The day I was called to interpret the Pharaoh's dream, I sensed God was about to transform the ugly duckling that I was into a swan. I expounded the dream, and the rest is history. Of the many hats I wore, as a beloved son, an envied brother, a betrayed slave, a hopeless prisoner, ruler of Egypt, I prize being labeled as the servant of God the most. The more God stretched and broke me, He revealed how much He was going to use me.
I know my exaltation comes only from the Lord. Psalms 75:7.
My heart abounds with gratitude. I harbor no revenge, only a deep longing for my big family, and God filled that vacuum too. When He caused the famine and my brothers came knocking at my doorstep, they felt the guilt, but I knew God had meant the evil for good. Genesis 50:20. Yes, Joseph's life exposes his integrity amid adversity and prosperity, and the reward of waiting on the Lord. With positive attitude and divine perspective, he translated the hurtful injustice as the preparatory design of God. Genesis 45:5. How closely his life mirrors the life of Jesus, both specially loved by the Father, resisted temptation, sold for silver, falsely accused, stripped off the clothing, but ending gloriously with revelation and reconciliation. Does your life feel like a maze? Take heart. Cloud of witnesses like Esther, David, Moses, and several such all proclaim how the author and perfecter of faith can break strongholds, charter new courses, all in a trice. As in Luke 1:37,
nothing is impossible in God.
Delays prepare us spiritually and make us more thankful.
In His time, He makes everything beautiful. Ecclesiastes 3:11.
Joseph challenges us to persist consistently in stoic faith. God blesses all. Amen.